Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to explain about the single channel queue problem. And the question what they're given is a small grocery store has only one checkout counter, and the customer arrives at this checkout counter at the random times that are from 1 to 8 minutes apart. And each possible value of an inter-arrival time has a probability of occurrence. The service time varies from 1 to 6 minutes apart with the probability as shown in the table. In this table, they are given the service time that is 1 to 6 minutes apart, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the probability they are given is 0.10, 0.20, 0.30, 0.25. 0.10 and 0.05. The problem is to analyze the system by simulating the arrival at service of 10 customers. We have to analyze the system by simulating the arrival at services of 10 customers. So the random digit of inter-arrival time they are given here. It's here the 9 values they are given. So it means that the first value is 0, inter-arrival time. When they are going to arrive at the 0th minute. So, we are going to take that the first value is 0. And the random digit for service time. These are the random digits they are given. See here, they are given it as the 10 values they are given. So, this is the question they are given. So, here you can able to see here the given. What they are given? The probability of inter-arrival time is 1 to 8 minutes apart. So, it is the probability is 1 divided by 8, that is 0.125. For one customer, the probability is 0.125. Why? Because the probability of arrival time, they are given it is 1 to 8 minutes apart. So, the next is the number of customers, they are given it is 10 customers. And the service time, it is 1 to 6 minutes apart. Now we have to calculate the distribution of time arrived. This distribution of time here arrived is 1 to 8 minutes. The time between arrival they are given it is 1 to 8 minutes. And for that 1 to 8 minutes they are given it's a probability of 0.125 for all the 8 values we have to write down 0.125 itself. And the cumulative probability means we have to add this probability. So cumulative probability, the first value is nothing but 1.25 itself. And the next value we have to add 1.25 and 1.25. 1.25 and 1.25, that is nothing but 0.250. And again here we have to add these three. So you are going to get 0.375. That is 1.25, 0.1. 0.25, 0.125. So all these three, if I add 0.375, we are going to get, or else you can add 0.250 and 0.125, you are going to get 0.375. So now if I add all these four, you are going to get a value 0.500, or else 0.375 plus 0.125, if you add this 0.500 you are going to get. And the next value is, if you add all the 5 value, that is 0.125, then you are going to get 0.625. again, if you add all the 6 values, you are going to get 0.750. if you add all the 7 values, you are going to get 0.875. now add all the 8 values, or 0.875 plus 0.125 together, you are going to get 1.00. So this is the cumulative probability for the distribution of the time arrived. Then the random digit assignment. Here after the decimal we have a 3 digits, so consider it as 00 12 125. So here it is a 3 digit number. After decimal we have a 3 digits. So the random digit assignment is, we must assign the value in 3 digits. And the next value is 0.250 is there. So the next value lies from 126 to 250, and the next value we have 0.375. So the next random digit is 251 to 375, and the next value, that is 376 to 376 to 500, and the next value is 501 to 625, and the next value 626 to 750, and the next value, it is 751 to 875, and the next value here 876 to 1000 we have to write, but here we should not write 1000, we have to write it as 0. Why? Because the random digit lies between 0 and 1, so the values should be between 1 and 0. So the last value, it is 0 itself. And the next table, service time distribution. Service time, they are given, it is 1 to 6 minutes apart, and the probability given in the table. These are the probabilities they are given in the table. So next we have to calculate the cumulative probability. The first value is, here we have 0.10, and these two values we have to add so that we are going to get a next value 0.30. The next cumulative probability, so that we have to add all these previous three probabilities, or else 0.30 and 0.30 together, if you add, you are going to get 0.60. The next value is 0.60 plus 0.25, or else you add all these four probabilities, then you are going to get 0.85. Again, 0.85 plus 0.10, that is nothing but 0.95. Again, 0.95 plus 0.05, the value you are going to get 1.00. The random digit assignment, we have to, after the decimal, we have two digits here. So we have to assign the values in two digits, that is from 0 1 to 1 0, that is after the decimal value, it's 1 0, it's there. So we are going to assign the 1 0, and the next number starts from 11 to 30, so after decimal we have a 30. So the next value is 31 to 60. Again, the next value lies from 61 to 85. Again, the next value lies in between 86 to 95. Again, the next value lies in between 96 to 00. You should not write 100, because the random digit always lies between 1 to 0. So we are going to write it 00 itself. In the next table, we have to calculate the time between arrival distribution. How we are going to calculate a time between the arrival distribution is nothing but using this table 1, distribution of the time arrival. The number of customers, for how many customers we have to calculate. The question they are given, it is for 10 customers. So we have to calculate it for 10 customers, and this random digit they are given. So for the first customer, the time between arrival, the first customer arrives at 0th minute. So there is no time between arrival for the first customer. So we are going to leave that as empty, and the remaining random digits, 9 random digits, what they are given in the question, we are going to assign the value over here. Now we have to calculate the inter-arrival time. How we are going to calculate the inter-arrival time? Random digit for the customer 2, it's 64. So random digit for the customer 2, and that 64 lies in between 1 to 125. So 1 to 125, the time between arrival, that is inter-arrival time, is 1 itself. Why? Because the 64 lies in 1 to 125. So the time between arrival at that time is 1. So inter-arrival time, the value is 1. Next value is 112. So 112 lies between 001 to 125. So that is the time between arrival at that particular value is 1. So inter-arrival time, it will become 1 itself. Now next value is 678. 678 lies in between 626 to 750. So this value, again here the time between arrival is 6 minutes. So we are going to write the inter-arrival time, the value is 6. The next value is 289. 289 lies in between 251 to 375. So at that time, the time between arrival is 3. So we are going to enter the value, it is 3. Again here 871. So 871, the random digit lies here, that is 751 to 875. So at that particular time between arrival in terms of minutes, it is 7. So we are going to write the value, it is 7 here. And the next value, that is 583. 583 lies in between 501 to 625. At that particular time, the time between arrival is 5. So we are going to enter the value, it is 5. Again, the 139 lies in between 126 to 250. So at that particular time, the time between the arrival is 2. So we are going to enter the value over here, it is 2. Again, 423 lies in between 376 to 423. Here the time between arrival in terms of minutes, it's 4 here. Again, 39, that for that time between the arrival, this 39 lies in between 01 to 125. At that time between the arrival is 1. So here we are going to enter the value, it is 1. And the next one, the service time distribution. The service time distribution, we have to see in the service time distribution table here. So the number of customers, we have 10 customers, and the random digit for the service time distribution, they are given in the question. So we have to enter the value here. The service time we have to calculate same like that what we did in a table 3. So 84 lies in between 61 to 85. At that time the service time is 4. So the service time value, it will become here the 4. Next value is 18. That 18 lies in between 11 to 30. At that time service time, it will become 2. Again 87 is there. So 87 lies between 86 to 95 though. So at that time the service time, it is 5. So we are going to enter the value, it is 5. Again 81 lies in between 61 to 85. So at that time the service time is 4. So we are going to enter the value, it is 4. Again the 6 random digit 1 to 10, the service time at that particular time is 1. So the service time we are going to enter it as 1. Again the 91 lies between 86 to 95. So the value we are going to enter, the value it is 5. Again the next value we are going to enter 79 lies in between 61 to 85. So at that particular time service time is 4. So we are going to enter it as 4. Again the for the 9 random digit we are going to get a value, it's 1. For 64 we are going to get a value, it is 4. And for 38 lies in between 31 to 60. So the service time at that particular minute is 3. So this is about the random digit arrival, cumulative probability calculation, random digit assignment, and inter-arrival time calculation, and the service time calculation. Now the actual simulation table, we have to do it. We have to calculate this for the 10 customer. Now the inter-arrival time. What is the inter-arrival time? We calculated that inter-arrival time in the previous table. So we have to see the previous table for inter-arrival time. What are the inter-arrival times we have? You just here it's inter-arrival time is there. You just copy it and we are going to enter those values over here. So inter-arrival time. And the next value is arrival time. Arrival time is nothing but at what time the customer is arrived. The first customer usually is arrived, we are going to consider it as is arrived at 0th minute. And the next customer is arrived, inter arrival time they are given it as 1. So here is arrived at the first minute. And the next customer, the customer 3 is arrived at, inter arrival time is 1, but the arrival time, this is 1 plus 1, then the arrival time we are going to enter that value, it is 2. Again, here 2 plus 6, we are going to get the value, it's 8. Again, 8 plus 3, we are going to get a value, it is 11. Again, 11 plus 7, we are going to get a value, it's 18. And 18 plus 5, it is 23. Again, the next value, 23 plus 2, it is 25. Again, 25 plus 4, it is 29. Again, 29 plus 1, the value, it is 30. So, arrival time, it's 30. You can see here, inter-arrival time, it's the sum of the inter-arrival time, we are going to get it is 30. And the arrival time for the last customer, we must get it is 30. Then, whatever we calculated, it's a correct value. Then the service time. Service time, it's we calculated in a previous table. So you just copy it over here for the, all the 10 customers. And we are going to enter these values in this table. That is service time. So the next value, time service begins. At what time the time service is going to begin? So the time service begin at 0th minute. Why? Because the customer is arrived at 0th minute. The time service is going to be 0 itself. Why waiting time in a queue? There is no waiting time. As soon as the customer has arrived, the time service is going to start. Service time ends. At what time the service is going to end? So here the customer is arrived at 0th minute and his service time we have it is 4. The 4 minutes he is served in a server. So at the time service ends at 4th minute itself. So the time customer spends in a system, he arrived at 0th minute and his service time is 4 minutes. So he spent the time in a system is 4 minutes itself. And the idle time, there is no idle time of the server. So the server, when this it started its work, he served it for 4 minutes without any idle. So this is the calculation for the first customer. And for the next customer, the time service begins here. See, you can see here service time. He is arrived at inter-arrival time is 1 and arrival time is 1. The second customer arrival time is 1. Even though he is arriving at the first minute and the time service it's going to begin at 4th minute. Why it is going to begin at the 4th minute? Because the first customer is going to end his work at 4th minute. Until unless if the first customer finishes his work, the second customer can't start his work. Even though the second customer arrived at 1st minute, he is going to start his works at 4th minute. So waiting time in a queue, how many minutes he waited then? He arrived at the 1st minute and he started at his work as 4th minute, he is waited for 3 minutes of time. So he is waited at 3 minutes. Then time service ends. At what time the service is going to end here? So he started a work at 4th minute and service time is 2 minutes. So 4th minute, he started work at 4th minute and he is provided a service for 2 minutes. So he is provided, so service time ends at 6th minutes. So the time customer spent in a system, how many minutes he spent in a system? He arrived at the 1st minute and he waited for 3 minutes. He waited for 3 minutes and his service time is for 2 minutes. So total together you are going to get it is 5 minutes. And idle time of the server. There is any server idle here? No, server is not idle till 6 minutes. He is providing a service. Next is time service begin for the third customer. At what time the previous customer is going to end its service? At 6 minutes. The arrival time of the third customer is at 2nd minute. But still he is going to start its service at 6th minute itself. Waiting time in a queue. How many minutes he waited then? He arrived at the 2 minutes but he got a service at 6th minute. So waiting time in a queue is it's 4 minutes. Again the time service ends. He started his work at 6th minute and the service time here for the it's 5. So 6 plus 5, it's 11. So 11. Again, the time customer spend in a system. How many minutes the customer spend in a system? That is, he arrived at the 2 minutes, but he waited for 4 minutes and his service time is of 5 minutes. So 4 plus 5. He waited for 4 minutes and his service time is 5 minutes. So total together it is 9 minutes. And the idle time of the server is 0 itself. Again, the time service begins. At what time it is arrived? 8th minute. But the previous customer, the third customer, is going to end its service at 11th minute. So, is going to start its work at 11th minute itself. The waiting time in a queue. He arrived at 8th minute, but his service started at 11th minute. How many minutes he waited? That is 11 minus 8. 11 minus 8, it is 3. Again, the time service ends. At what time he started his work at 11th minute, his service time is 4 minutes. So 11 plus 4, it is 15. Again, the time customer spent in a system. How many minutes he spent in? That is waiting time plus the service time. It is 4 plus 3, it is 7. Idle time of the server. Server is not idle. He is providing a service from 0th minute to till 15th minute. He is providing a services. So, it is 0. Again, the time service begins. He arrived at 11th minute, but the previous customer is going to end a service at 15th minute. So, he is going to start at work at 15th minute itself. Even though he is arrived at 11th minute, he is going to start at service at 15th minute itself. So, waiting time of the server is 15 minus 11, it is 4. So, time service ends. He started his work at 15th minute and the service time is only 1 minute. So, 15 plus 1, it is 16. Again, the time customer spends in a system. How many minutes he waited? How many minutes he served? That is 4 minutes he waited and 1 minute is the service time. So, total together, it is 5 minutes. Idle time of the server is 0. Now, you can see here, the 6th customer is going to arrive at 18th minute and the 5th customer is going to end his service at 16th minute. 5th customer is going to finish its work at 16th minute. So, but the 6th customer is arrived at 18th minute. So, 2 minutes, that is from 16th minute to 18th minute, the 2 minutes the server is idle. It is not doing any work at all. So, the server is idle for 2 minutes here. Now, the time service begins. At what time the service is going to begin? When the customer is arrived, at that time the service is going to begin. So, it is 18 itself. It is not 16. It is 18. Because at the 16th minute, the 5th customer finished his work. At the 18th minute, the 6th customer is arrived. So, 18 we have to enter here. Waiting time? No. He arrived at 18th minute, started his work at 18th minutes itself. So, it is 0. The service time ends. He started at 18th minute plus the service time is 5. 18 plus 5, it is total together, it is 23. Customer spends in a system. How many minutes customer spend? Waiting time is 0. 0 plus the service time, it is 5. So, the next customer, that is service time end at 23 minute for the 6th customer. So, the 7th customer is arrived at 23 minute itself. So, he can start his work at 23 minute itself. So, waiting time in a queue, there is no waiting time. And idle time of the server, time service ends 23 plus 4, that is 27. 23 plus 4, it is 27. Time customer spends in a system, how many minutes? Waiting time is 0, 0 plus 4, service time is 4. So, total together, we are having 4. Here, the idle time of the server, no. He finished his work at 23, the next customer started his work at 23 itself. So, idle time of the server, it is 0. The next customer, the service time ends at 7. For the 7th customer, it is at 27 and 8th customer is arrived at 25th minute itself. even though he arrived at 25th minute, he is going to start at work at 27th minute itself. Why? Because 7th customer is going to finish his work at 27th minute itself. How many minutes he waited then? 2 minutes. He arrived at 25th minute and his service time begins at 27th minute. So, waiting time is 2 itself. So, now 27 plus how many minutes is going to get a service? That is 1 minute. So, total together, it is going to finish his work at 28th minute. The time customer spent in a system, that is waiting time plus the service time. Total together, we have the value, it is 2 and the idle time of the server is 0. Again, here the time service ends at 28th minute and the next customer is going to arrive at 29th minute. So, 1 minute the server is idle. So, he is going to ninth customer, the idle time of the server is 1 minute. Why? Because 8th customer is finished his work at 28th minute, but the 9th customer is started his work at 29th minute. So, there is a difference. 1 minute the server is idle. So, the idle time of the server is 1. Again, the time service begins. At what time the service is going to begin? 29th minute itself. So, he has arrived at 29th minute and he is getting a service at 29th minute itself. Waiting time in a queue, it is 0. He is not waited at all. He arrived at 29th minute and he get a service at 29th minute itself. Again, 29 plus the service time and end of the time is 33. Again, the next is the time customer spend in a system. How many minutes is spent in the system? That is 4 minutes itself. 4 plus waiting time is 0. That is 4 itself. Again, for the 10th customer, the time service ends for the 9th customer. It is 33. At 33 minutes. So, the next he is going to, 10th customer is going to start at 33 minutes itself. Even though he has arrived at 30 minutes. So, we have a waiting time here. It's 3 minutes he waited. After that, he arrived at 30 minutes. He got service at 33 minutes. So, 3 minutes he waited here. Service time ends. 33 plus the service time is 3 minutes. So, total together, we are going to get 36. And time customer spend in a system, that is waiting time plus the service time. Service time here it is 6. So, idle time of the server, we will be having a 0. So, if I add this inter-arrival time, the value I am going to get it is 30. If I add the service time, we are going to get the value it is 33. And the waiting time in a queue, if I add all this value, we are going to get it is 19. Idle time of the server is 3. And the next value, we have to calculate total time customer spend in a system. The total time the customer which is spend in a system is 52 minutes. Total, it is 52 minutes. Again, average waiting time. Now, we have to calculate the values. So, here average waiting time. How we are going to calculate the average waiting time? That is total waiting time divided by the number of customer. Total waiting time, we got a total waiting time, it is 19. So, total waiting time for of all the 10 customer, waiting time in a queue, waiting time total we are having, it is 19. 19 divided by 10, it is 1.9. Average service time. Service time is equal to total service time. That says total service time is 33. 33 divided by number of customer is 10. That is 3.3. So, the next one, the waiting time for those who wait. That is total waiting time. Total waiting time we have, it is 19. And the number of customers waiting. We have to count how many number of customers here they are waiting here. So, how many customers that they are waiting here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 6 customers are waiting here. So, we are going to enter the value. It is 6. 19 divided by 6 is 3.166. Again, the average time customer spends in a system. That is total time customer spend in a system. That is 52 divided by 10. That is 5.2. Again, average inter-arrival time. Average inter-arrival time is total inter-arrival time. Total inter-arrival time is 30 divided by inter-arrival time. How many inter-arrival times we are going to get? It is 9 years. 1 to 2, it is 1 inter-arrival time. 2 to 3 another inter-arrival time, 3 to 4 another inter-arrival time. So like that, from 1 for the 10 customer, inter-arrival times we are going to get it as 9 itself. So we have to enter the value here, it is 9. So 3.33. The probability of a customer has to wait in a queue. The probability of a customer who wait in a queue is 6 divided by 10, that is 0.6. The probability of idle time of the server, that is total idle time of the server, is 3 divided by 36. The time service end at the last customer. So the time service end for the last customer, it is 36. For the last customer, the value it is going to end, the end of the time service is 36 for the last customer. So we are going to enter a value 3 divided by 36. So 0.033. These are the sum of the values that we are going to calculate here. So thank you everyone for watching the video. If you like this video, you subscribe for the channel to watch more videos related to the subject system modeling and simulation. Share with your friends.